This beautiful girl was on vacation in a villa. When she was eating an apple, she suddenly cried out in panic. There was a man with a gun appearing outside the window. He was staring at her. There was another man following him. Seeing that, Jen immediately called her boyfriend. Richard went to the front and opened the door. He said these were his two friends and let them go inside. While Jen was getting dressed, Richard's friend named Stanley suddenly entered into her room. Jen had a hunch that this man wasn't good. Stanley sat down next to her and gave her a business card and told that her boyfriend had to go out and would come back after a while. Jen immediately stood up. At this point, Stanley became a pervert. Jen wanted to run away, but he pushed her against the wall. At this moment, another friend of Richard named Dimitri suddenly entered the room. He was just standing at the door, eating snacks and staring at the two of them. Stanley said, "Either you come to have fun with me or get out of the room." Jen looked at Dimitri with pleading eyes, but he didn't help. Dimitri was still standing there and eating chocolate. After that, he closed the door and left, while Jen just cried in despair. When Dimitri came out of the room, there was a cry for help inside. He quickly turned on the TV, and then turned the speaker volume to maximum. After that, he walked around the room but then turned to leave. He was also thinking a lot. He then took off his clothes and jumped into the pool. 10 minutes later, Jen's boyfriend returned. Richard found his two good friends a little strange. Stanley walked up to him and said, "You won't be angry, will you?" Hearing that, Richard ran into the room and found Jen crying on the bed. He quickly turned around and left. When waking up, Jen saw Richard in front of her. He just said, "It's okay, it was just a dream just now. What you just went through, I will take money to make up for it." Hearing that, Jen also understood. It turned out the man in front of her was just a bad guy. So they started arguing loudly. Richard then slapped Jen and made her fall to the ground. And even threatened her, "My friends are of course more important than you." At this moment, Stanley and Dimitri saw Jen running and Richard chasing after. The two also stood still for a few seconds, then suddenly stood up and chased after. While Jen was trying to run away on the rocky road, the other three men were also running after her. When running to the cliff, Jen stopped. The other three men also caught up in time. Richard told Jen not to jump down. Then he took out his phone and called the helicopter. And said that for hours later, they would come pick Jen up. After putting down the phone, Richard slowly approached Jen. Jen intended to jump off the cliff. Meanwhile, her boyfriend seemed to be trying to advise her. After Jen calmed down, Richard turned around and took a deep breath. After that, he pushed Jen off the cliff. Jen fell and was pierced by a tree branch. Seeing that, the three men above thought Jen was dead. Richard's actions scared Stanley and Dimitri. They didn't expect Richard to dare to kill people. After the three of them left, there was a drop of Jen's blood falling to the ground. Blood fell on the ant. After that, the blood fell a lot until the ant died. At this time, there were a lot of ants crawling on Jen's body. Suddenly, Jen woke up and looked around for a while. She then wanted to cry for help, but blood filled her nose and mouth. She reached out her hand and tried her best to get items that were dropped nearby. At this point, Jen didn't seem to feel the pain anymore. She reached for a lighter and put some hay on the side of the tree, and then lit it. The fire caught the dry branch, which made it break. Jen fell to the ground painfully. At this moment, those three men returned to the cliff again. They came to clean up the tracks and destroy the body. Jen heard the sound of a car engine. She tried to crawl away in excruciating pain. At this point, Dimitri threw away the Coke can he just drank and it almost hit Jen. That made her crawl even faster. The three of them went to the side of the cliff but couldn't see Jen. There was only a trace of the burned tree left. They couldn't understand that Jen was so badly injured, why wasn't she dead yet? Richard said, "Jen's strength is very strong." So they decided to go down to check. Jen heard the cars go away, but she also knew they were going down here. At night, they went down and saw traces on the ground. They found the phone. Richard saw blood stains on the corner of the rock and concluded that it was Jen's blood. Following the blood stain on the ground, they started chasing Jen. At midnight, they went to the river and found that Jen's blood had disappeared. They began to split up to find her. A few minutes later, Jen emerged from the water and slowly crawled ashore. When just raising the head, she saw Dimitri. Then she hurriedly found a rock and hid behind it. Jen saw the shotgun and went to get it. At this point, Dimitri was a little startled. Jen's eyes were extremely sharp and indignant. Then she pulled the trigger, but it didn't have bullets inside. Seeing that, Dimitri immediately went to grab the gun, and then knocked Jen to the ground. And even cursed her badly. He took out his phone to tell Richard and Stanley that he had found Jen. Hearing that, Stanley felt very relieved, then even listened to music. Just like that, Stanley sang in the car. At this point, Dimitri was torturing Jen. He kept pressing her head into the water. Jen was quick to get the knife lying on Dimitri, then stabbed Dimitri in the eye with a knife. Meanwhile, Stanley was still listening to music. Jen drove Dimitri's car out of there. She drove to a mountain cave and began to treat her wound. Jen's waist was pierced by a tree branch. She took out a can of beer and opened it to drink. She couldn't feel the pain anymore. Seeing the wound, Jen slowly lifted up her shirt. Suddenly Jen thought of a medicine that her boyfriend gave her last night. She opened the pendant and took out a small plastic bag. Those were two black objects that were very similar to insects. She then chewed them, but because they were too bitter, she spit them out. To stay alive and relieve the pain, Jen picked up and ate them again. After that, she tried to chew and swallow them. 3 minutes later, Jen was hallucinating and no longer felt pain. Because this medicine would make people feel no pain even if their legs were amputated. Jen seemed to be getting silly. She gently touched her thigh, picked up the beer can and spilled it on the ground. She took a knife to cut a beer can and put it above the fire. After that, she pulled out the dry branch from her waist without feeling any pain. And took a beer can that had just been heated up and pressed it on her wound. Because of losing so much blood, Jen fainted. At noon the next day, Jen just woke up. At this time, Richard was also back. He called Stanley up. While washing the face, Stanley discovered Dimitri's body. He was so scared that he fell into the water. After that, Richard and Stanley split up to find Jen. But Richard suddenly turned around and punched Stanley. This action was like he pushed Jen off the cliff. Fortunately, Jen's wound had healed. She touched the eagle seal on her wound. It represented Jen's return to revenge. Jen picked up the shotgun and saw Richard appear. When he opened fire, Jen woke up from her dream. She slowly crawled up and picked up her shotgun. But unexpectedly, she saw that Richard and Stanley appeared again. Jen was so scared and ran out like a madman. On the way, she met herself, then she woke up in a panic again. Everything around was still as usual. Jen stood up to go out. She took out the binoculars to observe and suddenly noticed a ray of light. It turned out that Stanley was looking in the mirror. He was discovered by Jen. She frantically chased Stanley's car. She started to raise her gun. When Stanley was stopping for gas, she opened fire, but he wasn't dead yet. Because the recoil was too strong, Jen fell back. After standing up, she didn't see Stanley. Jen approached the car and saw blood stains on the ground. She followed the blood stain to chase Stanley. But suddenly the blood stain was gone, there was only one shoe on the ground. Jen didn't know Stanley was hiding above. He endured the pain and picked up his shotgun, but he couldn't shoot properly. He pulled the trigger and shot Jen in the ear. Jen hastily ran away, but Stanley was still chasing after her. Jen smashed the flashlight in her hand. At this time, Stanley was stepped on sharp pieces of glass. Then he painfully got back into the car and drove in the direction Jen ran away from. Meanwhile, Jen was also waiting for him. She fired repeatedly at Stanley but all failed. However, on the last shot, she shot through Stanley's head. After that, Jen took that car and left. At this point, Richard returned to the villa. He made contact with the helicopter. But when he was about to leave, Jen suddenly appeared. Jen shot him dead on the spot. This beautiful girl was forced into a dead end by three men. This movie wants to convey, never rape women. Otherwise, you will have to bear the painful consequences.